وخلق منها زوجها فبص منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. وفي آية أخرى يقول سبحانه وتعالى فاتقوا الله يا أولي الألباب لعلكم تفلحون. موضوع خطبتنا اليوم تتعلق على الأمانة كما قال الله سبحانه وتعالى في القرآن إنا أردنا الأمانة على السماوات والأرض والجبال فأبين أن يحملناها وأشفقنا منها وحملها الإنسان إنه كان ظلما جهولا. وفي آية أخرى من سورة النساء يقول سبحانه وتعالى إن الله يأمركم أن تؤدوا الأمانات إلى أهلها وإذا حكمتم بين الناس أن تهدوا بالعدل إن الله نعيم ما يعزكم به إن الله كان سميعا بصيرا. يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في حديثه عن أبي هريرة عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال آيات المنافق ثلاثة إذا حدث كذب وإذا وعد أخلف وإذا اؤتمن خان. رواه البخاري. وفي حديث أيضا عن زمزم بن مدبرد قال سمعت عمران بن حسين رضي الله عنهما عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال خيركم قرني ثم الذين يلونهم ثم يلونهم ثم يلونهم ثم يكون بعدهم قوم يشهدون ولا يستشهدون ويكونون ولا يؤتمنون وينظرون ولا يفتون ويذهب فيهم ثمن. رواه البخاري. وبين الله سبحانه وتعالى خصيصا الإسلام. I wish to start today's khutbah in the gracious name of Allah, the beneficent, the merciful. Allah is one without equal. Allah is one without associate. Allah is one without counterpart. Allah is one without beginning. Allah is one without an end. He was never created, he created all beings, known and unknown to mankind. Without seeing any picture, or design because he created all things. When he finished the creation of mankind, he said, "Lakode falatina li insana fi ahasani takwin." We testify that he is one at the beginning. He is the same one now. And when there will be nothing again, he will remain to be the only one. We testify to the messengership of Maulana Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the best of mankind whom Allah has raised to deliver mankind from all shackles of darknesses, to lead mankind to salvation, to the known, the light of Al-Islam. And this man came to this world without missing work. He never allowed family ties, friendship, environmental factors to prevent him from delivering the message. He doesn't care who is affected. Even when it concerns him, he delivered a message like that. May the peace and salutations of Allah be upon the noble soul of Maulana Mustafa Muhammad, his household, the companions, and those who stood with him in the days of adversity. Those who migrated from Makkah to Medina, the Ansar who received them in Medina. And by extension, to each and every one of you who have resolved, you didn't meet Muhammad, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But you have resolved that you will not do any other thing except that which the people now have brought to this world. May the peace and blessings of Allah be upon each and every one of us. Today, inshallah, with the time available, we want to look at a principle in Islam called Al-Amana. Al-Amana, in some languages, it is never translated. Because it's all encompassing, it has various meanings. For that reason, it remains to be a manner. Yoruba, we call it a manner. When our people to speak about it, we call it a manner. And when you find English translation of this a manner, there are various words or descriptive words used to translate it. One may be not exactly the same as other, but all together, when you bring it together, it is a manner. Why do we want to look at a manner today? We see a manner that it is a principle that even before Islam, before the Prophet Muhammad was raised to the world as prophet and messenger of Allah, he has cultivated that habit, and it brought confidence. It made the Meccans at that time to have trust in him. They accepted him as the judge. They accepted that if I keep something with him, then you find it will be so. That is the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And today, because we are lacking a manner, your next brother, blood brother, schoolmate, office mate, you cannot even leave your phone set to his custody. Why? Because we have lost a manner. Sometimes, when the issue of a manner is raised, we think it's only people in authority, in government, in politics that we are talking about. But before we finish today's khutbah, we want to see that a manner is not only by those who are occupying offices. You and me need to uphold the principle of a manner. Obedient servants of Allah, like I said, the theme of today's khutbah is about a manner. A manner may be translated as trust, it may be translated as honesty, it may be translated as moral responsibility and fulfillment of obligations. When you put all this together, in fact, it's not sufficient to explain a manner itself. But at each of these parts, you will see that it's giving information about a manner. And sometimes, depending on the application of that word, it can mean either of those words I've mentioned. It can mean trust, it can mean honesty, it can mean moral responsibility. And in the process, we will see how is a manner meaning moral responsibility. It can mean fulfillment of obligations, obligation between you and Allah, obligation between you and other human being, obligation between you and animal or other creatures of Allah. A manner can mean that. All these, if Allah permits, we will look at that in this presentation. A manner is an attribute that whoever possesses it will make other people feel secured in his hands. They will feel confident and positive about his actions and even his inactions. Such a person will not only be reliable, but he will be dependable and accommodable. Therefore, somebody who has a manner that you have tested him, you will be able to depend on him, not only depending on him, but you will be able to, you will find him to be a reliable person, and you will find him to be accommodating. You will find him that is honest, is trustworthy. All this you find in whoever has a manner. If it is by individual, that will be seen in group of people, you will find that. In a nation, you find it. And when it is not there, we see all the other proportions. A manner can be attribute of an individual group of people or a community. The lack of this attribute is manifested in different symptoms. It rears its head in different forms. Where there's no a manner in an individual group of people or community or even a nation, there are several symptoms you will see. And that will be, and each of these symptoms will have the same root back to lack of a manner. And when there is lack of a manner, it may lead to social, civil, or religious imbalances in the society. When there is no a manner. Ibadallah, the following is the various ways by which a manner is discussed by Allah and His Rasul, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. A manner encompasses all religious duties imposed upon us in Shariat al-Islamiyah. What are all is mentioned about the do's and the don'ts. You must do this, you must not do this. As long as the Quran has said it, as long as we find it in the authentic traditions of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it becomes amana. Amana to do or amana that you must not do. If it is amana to do, you are doing it. If it is amana that you should not do, you will not find doing it. When it is to be done and you are not doing it, you don't have amana. When it's not to be done and you are doing it, then you don't have amana. But if it's due and you are doing, that is an attribute of amana in you. If it is don't do and you are not doing it, then the quality of amana is already embedded in you. How do we see all obligations contained in Quran and Sunnah as amana? The evidence is contained in the first one of the verses recited in Arabic, where Allah said in Surah Al-Ahzab, "Inna a'adna li'amanata ala as-samawati wal-ardi wal-jibal fa'abayna an ya'malnaha wa ashfaqna minha wa hamalaha li'insan innahu kana zuluman jahula." Why do we say it's totality? Because Allah was not particular. Inna a'adna li'amanata, which amana is it? Allah was general. For it to be general here means that everything that is contains in terms of do or don't, that is what is called amana. And that will not be amana between you and Allah. What Allah said you should do, that is amana between you and Allah. Don't do, that's amana between you and Allah. And that is where in some verses of Quran, Allah will tell us about other animals. Can they worship Allah? It's only that doesn't see how they worship Allah. You know how they come to the mosque, they want to worship Allah. The amana they have taken, they are already doing it. He even said, even your shade, your image, in the force of worship Allah, that is just the amana that are taken. And not ask other than that which he was commanded to do. Yet Allah said, we did indeed offer the trust to the heavens and the earth and the mountains, but they refused to undertake it, being afraid thereof. They gave God this and they said they cannot take it. But mankind accepted it. Therefore, what we have accepted is contained in our Quran. What we have accepted is contained in the practical life of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and his scholars, those who lived in the day. As it will show that all art commanded in our Quran is ibadah. Prophet Ibrahim was reported to have been commanded to say, when he surrendered completely, he said, "Inna salati wa nusuki wa mahyaya wa mamati lillahi rabbil alamin." He says the submission to Allah, salat, zakat, striving, song, zakat, hajj, and all other things, even building the walidain, is everything. It is for Allah. Because he has commanded it, and he wants to give it to Allah, and he's giving it to him. That is amana. That is the peak of it. When you are at that level, that I'm doing it because Allah said I should do it. I will not do it because Allah said I should not do it. Not because of anybody. That will be the peak of rendering the amana as it ought to be. If my implication is in your office, and that is what you are doing, yes, that is amana as far as that is concerned. Secondly, the gift of Allah in terms of facilities required to live a normal life, to live a living. All the facilities Allah has provided, they are amana. Your limbs, your eye or sight, your hearing, your sensory organs, your limbs, ability to speak, and other things like that. That Allah has given mankind, that with it you now see yourself as human being. All of these things is amana. Why is it amana? Will you say that which he said you should not say? Will you touch that which Allah said you should not touch? Will you walk to where Allah said you should not walk to? Do you want to listen to what Allah said you should not listen to, or you will listen to what he said you should listen to? When you use all those names, then you are rendering the amana as it ought to be rendered. But when you fail to do that, then you have failed in the amana, and there are consequences for that. To emphasize that all the links, faculties, sensory that you are giving to us is amana, and must be used as far as Allah wants us to use it. Allah said, وَلَكَ كُمَانْ لَيْسَ لَكَ بِهِ إِلِمٌ إِنَّ السَّمْعَ وَالْبَصَرَ وَالْفُؤَادَ كُلُّ أُولَٰئِكَ كَانَ عَنْهُ مَسْئُولًا. Allah said, never do you dabble into affairs that you have no knowledge about. They ask you, I'm just looking. Just looking? Have you forgotten that nothing will you utter that will not be recorded? Everything. You say, I'm just looking. They are looking for it. I said, no. I decided to keep it somewhere. Is it yours? Why are you asked to keep it? Is it? You don't do that. Therefore, everything that is given to you to facilitate your living, to facilitate the obedience of Allah, to facilitate the first amanah we said about the obligations of Allah, all those things Allah will ask you concerning it. You need to have sight to be able to read the Quran. You need to have sight to be able to understand some other ayat of Allah. You need your limbs to carry some things, and all those things Allah has given it, and Allah will ask you concerning them. If you use it well, then you are upholding amanah. Thirdly, your wife and your children, they are amanah. They are not rights, they are privileges. Mankind will love to be wealthy, and mankind will love to have children. But Allah has warned us, all these things must be used to serve Allah. Somewhere he told us, he said, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu, la tulhikum amwalukum wala awladukum an dhikrillah. He said, never all you who believe, never you allow your children and your wife to divide you from worshipping Allah. Brothers and sisters in Islam, today, what is the cause of Medina in the world today? But okay, in our locality, let us leave the world. In our locality, I've localized it to Nigeria. Is it not because a parent wants to bequeath mansion for the children? Want to have money in all denominations? I'm not talking of Naira Kobo. Naira Kobo, because it's watering, valueless now. People are not interested in that. In hard currency, know the proper currency, you know it better than me. Yes, that's what you want to stockpile. Why? Is it because of what they want to eat? No. Most of them, if you give them about 20 naira, they can't eat finish it. Those who are stockpiling this way, they can't. But it's because of their children. And I said, La tulihikum amwalukum wala awladukum an dhikrillah. Why do you want to? Because you want to be noted as the richest man in your community, richest man in your state, or the richest man in Nigeria or in Africa or in the world. Why? You now want to use that to divide from worshiping Allah. Therefore, your wife and your children, they are instruments to be used to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah will ask you concerning all this. Fourthly, your job, be it private or public, be you employee or employer of labor, is also a man. Whatever job you are doing, you as a student, your studentship is a man. You as academic staff, your position as academic staff is a man. You are not academic but administrative staff. It is a man. Oh, you are only supporting services, you are providing supportive services. That service you are rendering is amanah. Allah will ask you concerning the rules and regulations governing whatever you are doing. Be it private, public, employer, employee, and whatever you may be doing. That job, that opportunity, there are thousands of people who want the same thing that you have, and they don't get it. And you want to see, you think it is free? Wallahi is not free. I say, Wallahi is not free. You know how many people apply as students, apply to the University of Glory during this last exercise? I doubt if they have taken more than 10% of those who apply. I doubt if they are taking more than 20% of those who are qualified to be taken. Yes, you have it and say, it's not a manner. Now that will ask you how you use it. As academics, sir, this is an exam period. How are you dealing with whatever has entrusted to you? Some of us, we harass. It's not only the aggressor that is harassing students. Even students also harass at the start. If you harass, is that what Allah has given those things to be used for? Allah will answer. Therefore, failure to keep the rules concerning each of these levels is the source of the fitina we have around us. So, if you say, part of the Quran, we are going to صلى الله وكل قرن سديدا يصلح لكم على نقل ان كلكم من بطن ومن يطيع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. الحمد لله الذي نزل القرآن على عبده ليكون للعالمين هدى ورحمة. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله على طوعه. ولقد يسرنا القرآن للذكر فهل من مدكر. وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. آمين. أيها المسلمون اعلموا أن الله يأمركم أن تؤدوا الأمانة إلى أهلها كما ثبت في آيات من سورة النساء. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. إن الله يأمركم أن تؤدوا الأمانات إلى أهلها وإذا حكمتم بين الناس أن تحكموا بالعدل إن الله نعم يعظكم به إن الله كان سميعا بصيرا. Some of those things we are able to enumerate. Another thing that we also know that we do not mention because of time, we have not been able to even translate any of the hadith of the Prophet of Salah. All of those things are not summarized in this surah, in this ayah. It's not in the Surah Quran, chapter 4, verse 58. Allah said, Inna Allah ya'murukum. It's not just free. Allah commands you that, and to add to the amanati ila ahliha. Return the trust given to you back to the owner. Return it back. Allah has given it to you. Let it be back to Allah. Preserve it and let it have it back. Human being has given it to you. Return it back to that person as it was given to you. Don't reject it. Amana is so important. Even at the point of death, he wants to assassinate the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. He was leaving Mecca. You know this history. He was leaving Mecca. He left Ali that stayed behind. And he knew that the Arab outside wanted to kill Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. They were outside there. He said, don't go. Because A and B and no, C, they had this kept before us. And they didn't know we are leaving. But the instruction has come that we should leave this night. Therefore, Ali was leaving behind. He knows the life of Ali will go. The process, but because he wants to discharge the trust given to him, he left him behind. And because he was sincere about it, the person to discharge the trust also was sincere about it. Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was saved, Ali was also saved in the process, and he delivered each and every one of us. The amana before being given to us, let us return it as it ought to be. Question the fire is kept under your care. Please don't give it to any other person except the person that is supposed to have it. The computer system is kept in your custody. The password, don't give it to another person to see it. I'll send it through the mail and I will delete the mail. If you delete the mail, that is the human being. Why not the record with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? It's because we are forgotten this. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, each day we are getting closer to our grave. And we are preparing as if it's getting more distant away from us. We think of what you will do tomorrow. You never think of how you are going to meet your Allah tomorrow. You think of the dress you want to put on. You never think of the last cloth that you'll be shielded with. You think of how to defraud people. You never think of how to render account of what you are doing. If we think of all this, the repercussion of what we are doing, and we go back to Allah, Rabiatan Mahdiya. If If we only do that, that is the only way we say we have fulfilled the mission of this life. We want to remember at this point in time, our Vice Chancellor is in the last lap of his administration. May Allah make the remaining better than the past. Remember our Imam, may Allah continue to give him the visionary leadership and Allah continue to strengthen him to deliver the message of Al-Islam. We remember each and every one of us who has made the whole that possible. Without you, a single person cannot make a Jama'ah. Therefore, may Allah answer each and every one of us. Our leader in the community, the area of the glory, and all other Muslim areas and covers, may Allah continue to preserve them for Islam. Remember our nation, the country, our president, may Allah grant him sound head with which to deliver message of Allah, with which to see that you can be in position of authority without being corrupt. May Allah grant him that ability. May Allah revive this nation for us. We don't have any other nation, it's this nation of ours. May Allah return it to return the glory back to Nigeria and to each and every one of us. ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أو أخطأنا. ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا. ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به. واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا أنت مولانا فاغفر لنا قوم الكافرين. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على قوم الكافرين. أقول قول هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم وسبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.